Today we are going to learn about the relation between design and governance. Different governance units influence how public infrastructure, for example, is manifested at the local scale. Governance is actually organizing activities of different sectors. That might be mobility, that might be water management. Looking, for example, now at the map of the Netherlands with the River Rhine and Waal, we see that public infrastructure also is crossing borders. We can see that, for example, the Rhine crosses a border between two nation states, between Germany and the Netherlands. But infrastructure does not only cross borders, it can build borders itself. So looking at this example, we can see the red line, which represents the border between two provinces of the Netherlands, Gelderland and North Brabant, is actually partially built of the Maas. Large-scale infrastructures like rivers are actually systems. Looking now at an example where we zoom in a bit, we can see on the left hand the river system, a water system, and on the right hand the transport system of the same city. A system usually is composed of parts, and these parts are interlinked. So we can see, for example, in the water system we have the main river flow, we have side river flows that flow into the main river, and then we have even smaller canals that interlink to the main system as well. Crossing already to adjacent urban environments, we see also that we have bridges linking from one to the other side. We have smaller bridges, and we have of course also tunnels. Coming to the other system, we can see in the transportation system we have the train, which is linking on a much larger scale. We have national roads, and then we have city scale arteries, and then we have the smaller, on the smaller level, the streets actually infiltrating the different districts. We can now understand these two different systems on its own, but we can also understand that of course they lay on top of each other, which means that these bridges crossing the water system are relevant in order to achieve the regional connection of the transportation system. Going a step ahead, besides the transportation, the water system, of course, you have also a governance system that can, for example, be, when we zoom out a little bit again to a regional scale, we have municipalities that are organized next to each other, and we see that maybe a main river flow is crossing these municipalities. Now, first of all, it might influence what is happening in this part. Upstream might influence what is happening in the lower part, or even in the lowest part, maybe already in a delta. Second, we can also have an influence through the governance units. For example, how different municipalities deal with implementing, manifesting the infrastructure on a local scale. Now, looking at these examples, we can see that maybe the third municipality here does not give a lot of space to water. As you can see in the section, the river is really embedded in a narrow bed, does not have a lot of space to widen. So we can imagine if we have a lot of rainfall here, the water is speeding up and has an effect more downstream. Looking now at the second example, maybe this municipality has more space or the policy to accommodate water in a different way. The river might extend from what we see here, the original river flow, to a larger surface. Maybe we can extend on both sides. That can be as a part of a nature recreation area. So we don't only have in the section the river bed, but also the chance to take larger surfaces. If you do not have a case like this, looking at the third case, maybe if you would have the whole river that is embedded in a very narrow river bed, most probably at some point where the river defense, the dike is weakest, maybe it breaks and we could have a flood. So it's very important that different municipalities on the one hand can act differently, but also the river itself influences, the different parts of the river influence what is happening here, has an impact on here and there. Looking at another example on how governance units or governance influences design, could be how we deal with the edge of a river. Looking at the first example here, we could design a nature park along the river, which gives good access to the residents, whoever lives next to the river. We can have the same in a very urban setting. We can create an urban waterfront, even though maybe we might not be able to touch the water, but we can interact, we can see the water quite well, we can approach the waterfront. In a negative case, like the third case here, we can see that the train infrastructure is bundled with the main river flow, which can create a very strong barrier, which basically prohibits that we can access the water. Finally, it is important to understand that interventions done on one scale can have an effect on a complete different scale. We can see here two different examples. The first one I want to discuss is a bridge. This is a very local intervention, basically concerning only one municipality, but it might have a regional effect if it facilitates a regional connection like a higher public train line or a larger highway system. Looking at the second case here, this is a nature park along the river. As you can see, it is substantially bigger than the bridge. It is much, much larger in extent, but it can have a much lower importance, a lower effect, let's say. Of course, it can also be of a regional attractiveness, but a first impact on the people that live close to it. As you could see from these examples, it is very important that governance and design are interlinked in order to find suitable solutions for specific situations.